So different types of environmental things that can affect aging. That's a lot of focus of your research has to do with various types of stress, whether it's diet related or psychologically related stress.
Right. So one way to think about all of those environmental things is to think about the exposome, all the factors that affect us that are outside of our skin. And so that includes I'm just going to list factors that are part of our exposome. A poor neighborhood that's dangerous, poor diet, junk food or processed food diet, being exposed to a lot of psychological stress at work or domestic violence. So these types of things that are outside of us are also related to shorter telomeres, all of the ones I just mentioned. And now there's a growing literature on chemical exposure. So this is very, very disturbing, because we're all exposed to these chemicals like BPA and Roundup, and these, a lot of these chemicals in plastics, et cetera, are mimicking estrogen. They're linked to greater risk sometimes of cancer or other diseases like diabetes, metabolic disease. And we can see, when we look at these aging biomarkers, we can see they're impacting them, inflammation and telomere shortening. So heavy metals, cadmium, lead, those are directly in a dose response way related to our telomere shortness.
Yeah, I think I actually read skimmed a recent publication of yours with the cadmium and
the metals. Lead. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, we're so exposed to that in chocolate and rice. I mean, that stuff is
definitely the arsenic, right. So it's alarming that we are exposed to so many chemicals and even small particles in our air pollution. And all of these are impacting our aging biology in ways we don't know. So telomeres are an easy marker that we can measure and index. What is the effect of these chemical exposures? And the National Institute of Environmental Health has become very interested in using telomeres as an index of exposures. So the, you know, in terms of your question of what in our environment is affecting us, more than we know, but so far we've determined that things that lead to psychological stress, like an unsafe neighborhood, of course, traumatic experiences leave an imprint on telomeres, particularly when they're in youth, in early in life. And then the nutrition data is, I would say, really not surprising and pretty consistent, which is whole foods, healthy diet are related to longer telomeres. And then you have the kind of foods that create this oxidative stress, inflammatory milieu, and those are related to shorter telomeres. So what do I mean by like the pro-inflammatory foods? So red meat, particularly processed meat, sugar drinks, particularly sugared soda, high sugar foods. So those are pretty much the culprits that stand out. Mostly we understand about food patterns, but there are some foods that pop out. Caffeinated coffee is associated with longer telomeres. Woo!
Yeah. And it was quite a bit of coffee, right?
Yeah, we just enjoyed it, Biggs.
Yeah.